South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol explores collaboration opportunities with Meta CEO Mark Zuckerberg in artificial intelligence and digital ecosystems. Yoon told Zuckerberg South Korea's portfolio of smart home appliances and cars offered a platform for Meta's AI technology. But he also urged Meta to play a more active role in monitoring and countering disinformation on its platforms. Zuckerberg is on his first publicly known visit to South Korea in a decade as part of an Asian tour that includes stops in Japan and India. A new study by global digital payments company Visa reveals the use of mobile wallets has become just as popular as using cash in the Philippines, where traditionally cash has always been king. We have the details from Andrea Taguides.
Payments via mobile wallets now at par with cash transactions in the Philippines. That's according to Visa's latest Consumer Payment Attitude Survey, which saw cash usage in the Philippines falling to 87% in 2023 from 96% in 2022. Mobile wallet usage also came in at 87%, with majority usually going for the QR code option. For Visa Country Manager for the Philippines, Jeff Navarro, this is proof that the cashless wave continues to gain momentum in the country, long after the lifting of COVID-19 lockdowns.
The momentum for attempting to go cashless has remained to be strong, and the confidence year on year has been increasing. In the past, there used to be a big disparity between cash, mobile, and cards. But what we've seen now is mobile payments now is more or less synonymous to the same way as 87% of cash.
Based on the study, 43% said they carried less cash in their wallets in 2023 compared to the previous year. It also found that 83% of Filipino consumers, led by the younger and affluent segments, even attempted to live without cash and were able to manage for an average of 10 days. Navarro attributed this growing confidence to go cashless to the increase in the number of establishments accepting digital payments.
Compared to last year, have you seen an increase in the number of merchants that support mobile wallets? 87% said yes. 63% also saw visibly an increase in card acceptance through swiping, and 52% believe and saw that it also increased for contactless. So dun nanggagaling yung level of confidence on why they now are okay to say, yes, I can survive without cash.
Supermarkets, food and dining, and bill payments were the leading merchant categories that consumers observed to have opened up acceptance of cashless payment methods. Catherine Cabaleo is among those who use an e-wallet to pay for groceries and utility bills.
Convenient kasi hindi ka na pupunta mismo sa Meralco, hindi ka na mismo pupunta sa Maynila, safe siya kapag wala kang dalang cash.
Moving forward, the Visa study also showed that 1 in 3 consumers see the Philippines becoming a cashless society by 2030. However, Navarro also acknowledged that internet connection is still a big problem in some areas in the country. That's why he said Visa is also looking at possible ways to facilitate offline cashless payments.
We're trying to work with some of our issuers and acquirers to see if we can do something that's offline. But these are very early discussions. There's still no concrete solution. But it's really one of those that we want to do because it again supports the national agenda of the government for financial inclusion.
He said they plan to be able to pilot a program this year, if not early next year. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.